when I hear music, it's very natural, and either you respond or you don't respond. You could, it's something that you feel in your gut. And photography at its best, for me, is something that is instantaneous. It's something that you feel in your gut. So my name is Jeff Kaufman, and I'm 53, and right now I'm living in Brantford, Connecticut. My business is still primarily in New York City. I've been a photographer both in the food world and portraiture for almost 30 years. When I was younger, I spent the formative years growing up in studios throughout New York. My father is a big band jazz musician, and my mother at the time was working for Perry Como's show as a script editor. My brother and I spent most of our weekends, and until we went to school, we were in the studios in New York. When I was younger, I guess the first choice for me, as far as profession was concerned, was to become an artist. I quickly realized that making a living as an artist was going to be very, very difficult. Photography came as a second idea, or almost by chance. Going through high school and college, I was studying art, and I used to spend a lot of time in the museums in New York copying some of my heroes, which include Rembrandt and Van Gogh and some of the old classic masters. When I went to school, though, State University, I decided to pursue English, and primarily the lure there was to learn how to write. After my first year of working in the workplace, I was hired as a writer for public relations, and I wound up doing graphic design and hiring photographers. And that's where I realized that you could actually make a living being a photographer. So I went back to school and I studied photography with some black and white printers first at the new school, one of whom was George Tice, who went on to produce a lot of Steichen's work, and then Dennis Simonetti also. Two conflicting ideas about black and white printing and technique, but for me, that was the thrill. That was what really got me involved in photography. That was the real passion. The creative process for me it's always been a natural process, and it kind of takes on its own path once you're put in an environment. So the thought process is more for me about eliminating all the distraction and just concentrating and focusing on what you're trying to convey. And it could take a lot of different aspects. One would be, in shooting portraiture, would be to try and convey some emotion or some something that's evocative in a face. And I, you know, certainly try to use lighting to convey that idea. In the food world, it's primarily about desire. So using texture and using light and using color, trying to focus on desire. They're completely different processes. One has got a lot more preparation going in, and the other one is much more spontaneous. So, but I think in either event, serendipity, things that happen by themselves, is what you really look for. I think for me, traveling around the world and in different big cities, whether it be Rome or Paris or Sao Paulo or Rio, for me, the easiest city to work with is New York, because I grew up there and everything is at your fingertips. I love New York City. I love every morning when I leave my house to go work in New York City. I get up at 3:30. I'm in New York an hour and a half later, and seeing New York with the sunrise coming across one of the bridges is probably the most romantic thing I've ever seen. So when I go in, I usually tell my wife and my children, my friends, that I'm having an affair with New York, because it's really bright and early in the morning, and it's very, very romantic. The music went off in the head, and your eyes would pop open, and it's just complete love. So visually, I adore New York, and then for all it has to offer in culture, in food, in music, all the things that I really love. A few weeks ago, I lost a buddy of mine who I know for about 50 years, someone who I grew up with. So I think in thinking about his life, I've also thought a lot about my own mortality, and I think I really would like to have a few images that mean something that have also affected other people's lives. I know the work I did in Haiti for sure helped a lot of people in fundraising and was able to actually have a concrete effect on people's lives. So that's on the professional side. And then in my life, I just want to make sure that there's been some effect, some generosity and some friendship. And I think those are the two things that I want to be remembered for.